everybody. So, somebody in our resale community recently went viral. He's actually still going viral right now. I haven't looked at his stats today, but this person is Resale Rabbit, and I've been watching his videos since he's been since he was thrifting with Rick and Profit. Ago, probably like 2 or 3 years ago. He's had around 20,000 subscribers, 20,000 to 30,000 recently. Well, he used to travel around the country going to thrift stores. He was really doing really well selling stuff on Amazon. He was sending shipments out from his hotel rooms, and I thought that was really cool. Really interesting for a YouTube channel. Not something a lot of people do, especially going to thrift stores. A lot of people travel for retail arbitrage, but going to thrift stores around the country is kind of unique. So recently he, I don't think he's selling on Amazon anymore, and he's transitioning to only selling on eBay. And he bought a warehouse. He's been buying storage units and pallets from liquidations. So he made two videos that kind of went viral. First video, he bought an Amazon pallet for Amazon returns. That was actually the premise of both videos. He bought some Amazon return pallets, and he was going through them. The videos were like an hour long, but they were live. One of the videos got 1 million views. Last time I looked, the other one had 3.6 million, which is insane. Most of his videos probably had anywhere between 10,000 views and 30,000 views. So for one to even have. And then he has another pallet that he bought from Target, another pallet video. That video had almost 400,000 views. So these pallets, a lot of people buying these pallets and showing it on YouTube are getting extremely popular. I've just noticed a lot of these pallet unboxing videos are getting hundreds of thousands of views, and Resale Rabbit, his subscribers just crossed it. He's probably crossed it now, 100,000 subscribers, which is insane. He didn't even post very much like 2 or 3 years ago. He probably posted once or twice a week. Shows you what virality can do. So he has more subscribers than people that have been posting for 6 and 7 years in their resale community. It's just crazy. And plus, his videos are monetized. So if we look at, like, most resale videos have high ad rates, so they can be anywhere from $3 per thousand views to $10 per thousand views. So I would probably guess it's around $5 per thousand is what he's getting. So that's just insane. So 1 million views would be $5,000. And one of his videos has 3 million. So that's like, he's probably made like 20 grand off of those two videos. It's just insane. And he only paid, let's see, he was buying the pallets for like $85 a piece. He bought 7 pallets. And so he paid like $600 ship it. So he's in those pallets for under $1,000, and he probably made 15 to 20 thousand off of those two videos. So I just want to talk about why those videos have gone viral. He says he doesn't know, but he did say that a lot of his traffic came from recommended videos. So he's showing up in the recommended section on YouTube. Now, why would YouTube do this? They want the most watch time. YouTube wants you to stay on their website for as long as possible. So with these videos being almost an hour long, that means his watch time is probably over 75%, is what I'm thinking. People are watching the whole video. If they're watching it, they want to see what he's finding. Plus, what he did, he ran a giveaway on one of those videos where he was giving away 10 items from those pallets. So a lot of, and he was giving them away to new subscribers. So that caused, that could be one thing that caused his subscribers to jump so high. He got almost, he got like 60 or 70,000 subscribers from those two videos. It's just amazing to see something happening like that to someone in the resale community. He's a really good guy. Like I said, I've been watching his videos for 2 or 3 years. I really enjoyed his thrifting videos because he shows what he buys and he tells you what he thinks he's going to get for it. And a lot of the stuff he sends to Amazon FBA in those videos, which is what I was doing at the time. It's what I'm still doing, but I'm doing more retail arbitrage than anything else. But I'm just happy for the guy. He's made a lot of money off those videos, and he's probably gonna keep making money off those subscribers. The good thing about him, he doesn't sell any courses. He doesn't sell any guides. He just gives it all away for free. So he has some unique business models. So with his storage units, he's having all the bad stuff in those units. He has like a garage sale. He posts on Facebook, "This is when I'm having my sale." And he sells everything at the sale for $1. So he'll have shelves and racks of clothes. He'll have books and everything that was in those storage units for $1. Not everything in the units. He'll take all the good stuff out, but and sell those on eBay. But all the, you know, like the trash that most people throw away, he sells stuff for $1. He sells that stuff for $1. I think it's pretty unique. A lot of what he does is pretty unique. And something that I do like about him is he takes stuff to local auctions. He doesn't really show that part of the business that much. He does have a couple videos of him talking about taking stuff there. He sold some sports cards there for pretty good money. So yeah. If you haven't seen his videos, make sure you check it out, and I'll see you next time.